I'm the science teacher who is going to, you know, violate all your expectations in the next 15 minutes. So are you ready for that? Yeah? Okay. So violation number one. Are plants vegetarian or non-vegetarian? Are you sure? How many of you say it's vegetarian? Plants. What about the organic matter roots taken? Okay, violation number two. I have a 2 GB pen drive and a 64 GB pen drive. Which is heavier? Which is heavier if I hold it on your hand? Yeah? But how come 64 GB pen drive can load more movies? Isn't it? Don't you think? Violation number three. We all learn that we should have balanced diet, right? Our teachers, our professors, our mamas, everyone says. Do animals have balanced diet? Like one day lion says, today I'm not going to kill deer. I will have grass instead. I need fiber more. Yeah? Or elephant says, let me kill a deer for a change. Yeah? No? Okay. That's me, by the way, 2011. That was the first day of my school. I was like, yeah. Let me tell you a story. Yeah? The story goes like this. There's an 8-year-old girl called Gappu. Yeah? So Gappu lives in an urban slum. And one morning she wakes up and she just scratches her hand, legs and everything. And she has not gotten sleep from quite a couple of days. And she just goes, walks out, and she just goes to a shop. No one is there. It's like 9 o'clock in the morning. Her mother has gone to work somewhere. Her father has also gone to work somewhere. No one is there. So she just goes, locks her hut, and goes to a shop. And she's a bit scared to be there in that shop. And she sees a very huge crowd over there, you know? But she takes up her courage and just go to the shop. And in that shop, just the moment she enters, everyone is very shocked. What this 8-year-old little girl is doing here in the shop? Then the girl goes to the shopkeeper and says, I want that. The shopkeeper gets very puzzled, very scared, in fact. What this 8-year-old girl is doing here? What if someone sees? If someone sees, police will catch me. Because it turns out that shop is a wine shop, alcohol shop. And what the girl is asking for is a bottle of alcohol. The shopkeeper gets very scared. By seeing the face of the scared face of the shopkeeper, what the girl does is, the girl takes up some crunch notes from her skirt and puts it on the table. There's a lot of crunch notes that she has saved from, you know, past 1 year. By seeing that, the shopkeeper gets very greedy now. Now he is in double mind. What should I do? Should I give her that alcohol? In his mind, it is thinking. He is thinking, how can I give that bottle to the little girl? But seeing that lot of money, he gets really greedy. And he decides, and he makes a choice. He makes a choice that he will give that alcohol bottle to the girl. Yeah? So the girl takes that alcohol bottle and just runs back. Runs back, and goes into the hut. Yeah? In the hut, she closes the door. No one is there. She's all alone. She takes up that alcohol bottle. She just inquisitively sees to the label of that alcohol bottle. And just sees the sticker. And she's just a bit scared. She just throws her back herself into the memories where her father drinks every day this bottle, the same bottle, comes back home and beats her mother. That scare, the screams of her mother is all over her, you know, by seeing that bottle. And then she becomes very inquisitive about that bottle as well. So what she does is she opens that bottle cap. The cap falls, tup, down. She takes up some small liquid in her hand. And she just sees again inquisitively, what's in it, this liquid, that makes my father, you know, to beat my mother. It's a very scary experience. Then she makes a choice again. What she does is, she's in the crossroads of making a choice, whether she can drink that, test it, and what if, who knows, she will end up becoming like his father. Or what she does, do you want to know? Who wants to know? Everyone wants to know what she does. She sprinkles that alcohol onto her bed because alcohol kills bed bugs. You can laugh now. Alcohol is a good acid that can, it's neither an acid or a base, but that can shut the pores of the bed bugs and it can kill bed bugs. That's what she wanted to experiment. Yeah? Okay. So, we are at a, as I said, at the age of 15, I was like once in my past life, it seems like a past life now, 12 years before, I was 15, more or less like you all. And I wanted three things in life, yeah? Pretty much three things if someone asked me. I wanted an American salary, I wanted to go to America, yeah? I wanted a German car, either an Audi or a BMW, and I wanted a beautiful Indian wife to marry. Three things, that's it, yeah? So engineering would have done the trick for me. So I persisted and I made a choice that I will become an engineer. But, and after splurging all my parents' money and savings into engineering, I decided and I made a choice and I told one day to my parents that I want to become a teacher. My parents were shocked. They said, "Agar teacher hi banna hota, if you wanted to become a teacher, you would have said before, after 12th. I said, "Now I want to become a teacher." So I went, yeah? And I went, and this was my first day of the school, like this. I was very passionate, I was very enthusiastic, and I was like, I felt myself that I am very overqualified because since I am an engineer, I can easily smooth away this teaching job, and I was into it. You know, just 15 days into it, 15 days, an 8-year-old kid comes to me and says, "Bhaiya, just shut up, take 100 rupees and now go. Enough of teaching." And that led me to think, you know, what is going on? It led me to think that the choice I made to become a teacher was that I was pretty much bored of the way actually I was given education. What I was received throughout my 21, 23 years of my life as in the name of education, I was pretty much bored and I wanted to change that. But I was pretty much becoming like that. And what is the reason, you know? So that led me to think more and that led me to this painting. Is this painting clear? Can this light be on for off, switched off for maybe 2 minutes so that this painting becomes clear? It's important because, yeah. Thank you so much. Can you see this painting? This painting is an 1872 painting called American Progress, okay? So if you can see that a white woman is floating across the American plains with a school book in her hand, see the lighting. It is the bright side and it is the dark side. The Westerners, the settlers, the white people are following her, right? Beyond that, there is a railway, the symbolism of progression at that time. And here, you can see the native Indians and the wild animals are fleeing. Yeah? In India too, I would like to quote this actually. We are following the Macaulay, pretty much the Macaulay education system, which is the 1835 he wrote, in the Minutes of Education. "We must at present do our best to form a class of persons, Indian in blood and color we are today, but English in taste, in opinions, in morals, and in intellect." Yeah? So this is what we has been following, and we know it, right? So, it's pretty shocking. So, this was it. This was the way the classrooms has been designed. This has been the way the education has been given to us. This has been the way we are consuming this education. Something is going wrong, is it not? Yeah, do you feel? There is a documentary of in 2000, how many earths we need. Yeah, it says that if we start today, if the whole earth, the 7 billion people in this earth starts living like an average American, we need 4 earths. Not 1, not 2, not 3, 4 earth. Today, at this point of time. It's like pretty much half of the solar system, isn't it? Yeah? So something is wrong with the way like we are consuming. We believe that we are spoiled with lot of choices. It's the world of the Amazons and the Flipkarts. If you click on the phone, actually we have like thousands of phones. We are spoiled with choices. But do we have really the choice? If we are not good in science and maths, we don't get into the big universities. If we are into arts and humanities, something he will do, maybe, as such. But yeah, let's see. It's pretty interesting. Are you a doctor? Wow. Are you an engineer? Wow. I want to pursue humanities, liberal arts. Oh, that's quite interesting. Mm. Yeah? Right? So just understand, right? Like, what is going on? What is happening? We are at a point of an academic inflection today. 90%, you all in this room are pretty smart people, and I'm pretty much amazed. At the age of 15, 16, I was not exposed to feminism, microfinance, entrepreneurship and all. And I'm pretty amazed that you're sitting all, right from morning to evening, listening to this, understanding this, at least thinking about it. But I am sure that 90% of, when I'm saying 90% of your peers, not in this room, but in this country, who will be graduating like with you, maybe 5 years down the line, or maybe 6 years down the line, they 90% of them will end up not getting jobs in this country. That's an ASCOM survey, I am not saying that. That's the result. We are at an academic inflection point. We are at a point, actually, we are materialistically spoiled with choices, but intelligence-wise, we are on a deprivation. So what is this education that we are like following? You know, that led me to this. Learning is fun and experiential. And the whole premise was, instead of what if the choices we give it to the students itself, what if the students like Gappu, how she did it? What if she makes a choice which is not compulsion, which is not because of any conditioning, which is not because the schools are saying or the parents are saying, or it is because ki bank's credit card de dega. You know, what if the children make choices, you know, where they are absolutely passionate about it and they have fun? Whatever it happens later, it's okay. How can we create that culture in the classrooms? How can we create that confidence in the children that they can pursue their dreams without getting scared about what is the C2C I will get? Will I land up getting a $100,000 job? Will the society will give me respect? So I will like to, what this learning is fun and experiential, I will show you in the next 30 seconds. For that, I would like to invite 4 volunteers. Any of you, please, can you come over here? 4 volunteers, who wants to come? Come, 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 just first come, first serve. There is no competition here, no sad. You can pick up those 4 things. One thing, I need 4 volunteers, you can think. Anyone, you can pick and choose. Yeah? Okay, who has the car? Can you blow that car for me? What's your name? Rashni, yeah? Can you blow that? You might have to blow it a bit harder, okay? Great, great, great. And just close that nib, close that nib. Put it down. Come here, come here, come here. Like this, I put it down. And leave it. You can just keep it. Just move aside. Yeah, that's okay. Yeah? This is what it is. It's a balloon car. You can learn almost 55 concepts of physics that you have learned, right from Newton's laws of motion to energy, displacement, acceleration, pressure, energy, everything, through this simple car. And you can make it, yeah, yourself. Okay, who has the pipe generator? Can you come over here? Cool. Can you just shake it? What is happening?
It's generating light.
It's generating light?
Yeah.
Does anyone want to test it? Can you try? Are you sure?
It's generating light?
Yeah.
Yeah? Pretty much?
Yeah.
Yeah. It generates light. And what you're seeing is simple this. There's a magnet over here. There's a copper coil. And it's an LED. LED is connected with the copper coil. And when the magnet rolls, oscillates, the light glows. And this is what we learn in a very complex way, that water falls, turbine rotates, shaft rotates, the armature coil inside the generator rotates, some induction happens, and electricity is generated, which is nothing but a flow of electrons. I didn't understand anything out of that till I saw this at the age of 25. Till that time, I just rote learned it, and I passed it, and I scored well, and I completed my engineering as well. Yeah? Okay. Can we just blow that? What is happening? There's some sound coming? When you blow it, touch your finger on the membrane part of it, the balloon part. While blowing, blow it, and with your finger, while blowing, with your finger, touch here. What is happening? It's vibrating. Can you sense the vibration? Yeah? Sound is nothing but a vibration, isn't it? That we learn. But it is simple as that. And you can use a paper cup to make it. My dear lady, what's your name? Meher. Okay, Meher. Can you do something for me, Meher? So, what you can do is, you hold it like this, so that they can see, and then you can just press it down. Press it down, press it up. Press it down, press it up. Press it down, press it up. And just tell me.
Can you tell others what is happening?
Like the balloon is contracting and expanding.
The balloon is
contracting and expanding. What is happening, by the way? Yeah? The chest is expanding. The air is coming in, inside the balloon, automatically. And when my chest is contracting, the air is going out, automatically. This is the breathing in and the breathing out process, isn't it? And this is it, the difference in pressure as well. Technical sides aside. But just imagine, what if we all learned it like this? What if we had an awesome learning experience like this in the classroom? Was I scared? Will I be scared actually? Oh, it is not working. What if others will think that it is not working? My model is not working. Will you be having the competition that, oh, that guy's model is working, mine is not? No, right? We'll be very free. We'll be very scare-free, fearless, and we will strive towards designing it. We'll strive towards making my own model. Wouldn't that be a nood? Beautiful experience for all of us, right? So that brings me to what we can all do, right? As Aldous Huxley, I told you, right? I will violate all your expectations in the next 15 minutes. So any experience that does not violate the expectations is not an experience at all. And what we are consuming in the name of, thank you all, thank you so much for coming over. So what we all are doing in the name of education is not learning, right? What is happening is we are getting educated. We are getting academically proficient, but we are not learning. We are not learning at all, right? In the classroom, teacher says something, the students get educated, but is the students learning? Are the students learning? And if that learning is not happening, then is it a classroom experience? No, right? If the patient comes to a doctor, the doctor gives something, and the patient is not cured, and the doctor says, I gave medicines. It is on the patient that he is not getting cured well. Is it that? Is it that not simple? No, right? The learning has to happen. And that's why this power of experiential learning. And we have been a land of that. We have been in India, actually, from traditionally thousands of years, actually, we have been the land of stories. We have been the land of experiences. This logics, this framework came later. It is very important, but it is not the part, and it is not the life in itself. Life is much more beautiful. Life is experience, right? So today, I have a wish. I have bought, actually, 50 balloon cars with me. I can give it to any one of you, actually, after this session. Make that balloon car, yeah? And gift that experience to anyone. Your parents, your sister, your father, your mother, anyone. But make that with them, and you will observe yourself how beautiful that experience can be. Yeah? And that's what I call science is an attitude. An attitude to think. An attitude to arouse the curiosity. And once that curiosity is aroused, how we can think about it. How we can explore ourselves. And how we can derive the learning out of it. Without fear, without being judged, without the fear of any exams, without the fear of any deadlines. How beautiful that experience can be. And you too can give that experience to anyone. Because all it takes is just, you know, 4 PET bottle caps that we get after drinking the Coca-Cola or the thumbs up, the bendable straw that you get actually after drinking the juice, toothpicks, some tape, and a balloon. And you can give that wonderful experience to yourself and to everyone all around so that they become fearless. Those memories stick with them, and they have the courage, like the Gappu, to make right choices in life and take right decisions that benefits everyone. Thank you so much.